Hey, my loves, it's your girl, Mary J. Welcome back to yet another video. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you guys how I got this bomb hair color that I'm rocking right now. It is this nice chocolate brown with some highlights. If you'd like to see how I achieved this color, please continue watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and enjoy. So guys, I started off, this is all the things that you are going to need. You're going to need bleach, you're going to need 40 volume developer, you're going to need the hair color, which is this Revlon hair color, some gloves of course, you're going to need a mixing bowl and a brush. And I didn't show you guys yet, but you're going to need foil paper as well. So here I am going in, I'm just scooping out some bleach into my mixing bowl. I'm gonna pour some developer in there and we're just gonna mix it up nice and smooth. I don't measure anything, it's just me eyeballing it and just putting as much bleach as I think that I'm going to need. So that's what I'm doing currently right now. And I'm doing this in my room, but I would advise for you guys not to do it in your room. It wasn't, messy, so I got away with it. But, if you're afraid that it's going to get messy, guys, don't do it in your room. Because you might get bleach or dye all over, and you don't want that. So here I am mixing the developer and the bleach together, and I'm trying to get a smooth consistency. So as I mentioned before, you are going to need foil paper. What I'm doing now is just cutting the foil paper in some good sizes. I did about 30. I would say I did about 30, but this is for the highlights in the hair. So what I did, I think I used a whole roll of foil paper. You want as many foil papers as highlights you're gonna have in your hair. And because I really plan on having a lot of highlights in this hair, I did as much foil paper as possible. So after applying my gloves, what I did to the hair is I separated it into sections. I did 3 sections, 2 on the side and 1 in the back. It's just easier to work in section, guys. So I would really advise that you divide the hair in sections and brush it really nicely. You don't want no tangles, no snags in the hair. And I am prepping and getting ready for the dyeing. And you're gonna need a tail comb. And the process that I'm using to get the highlights in the hair is called weaving. Now, guys, I am not a professional at all, nor do I claim to be, but you know, this is just what I've learned from watching other people and, you know, YouTubers as well. And I'm going to just section this hair out the way, and I'm going to use a technique called weaving. That is simply just using your tail comb and going kind of like a weaving technique. So you go in and up and down through the hair and just pulling out little sections of hair, which will be your highlights. I hope that I'm really explaining it well, but if not, I'm showing you guys what I'm doing, so hopefully that, you know, could help as well. Next, I am going to place a foil paper right underneath that the hair that I have pulled out, and I am going to apply the bleach on it. We are going to lift this hair as light as possible for so the highlights can be as dominating as possible. Not really, I didn't really want it like really, really light, but enough where you can tell that there are highlights in the hair. So that's what I'm doing currently right now. I'm just applying bleach to the hair, making sure every strand is coated with bleach. And then I am going to wrap it up and then repeat the same process. And that's all I did to the rest of the hair, guys. And I will continue to show you guys how I did that. And this is how it looked after I have completed putting all of the highlights into the hair. Now, I did went ahead and repeated this process twice because I wanted more highlights into the hair. And this is the finished product after I did it twice. I washed and air dried this hair, and this is how it currently looks. Guys, this color looks so nice. It looks bomb like this, but we are going in with some dye to make it as ashy as possible. I am using the color Silk and the color 60, which is medium ash brown, and this is gonna help tone the hair out and get rid of all that brassiness to it. So this is very simple, guys. All you do is pour in the mixture. It comes with two, so you just pour one into the other. You shake it really, really well, and then you just go ahead and apply it to the hair. Guys, like I said, I like to work in sections, and I advise for you to work in sections as well. So this is what I'm currently doing. I am sectioning the hair, making sure that it's enough where it's not a lot of hair, so I can be able to apply the dye, and every strand can receive dye. And that was me brushing it out, making sure there was no tangles in the hair, and I am just applying the dye directly on the hair. Nothing special. The number one key here is to make sure every strand of hair is coated with the dye, so therefore everything is seamless with this color. I was real generous with applying the dye onto the hair. I ended up using 4 boxes of dye. It was worth it, guys, because you don't want to run out of dye. So I made sure I purchased 4 boxes, and they were pretty cheap. They're at your local beauty supply, $3.99 or $4 around there. Yeah, around there. So this is very cheap. So I went ahead and purchased 4 boxes, and I used the entire 4 boxes in this wig. I was very generous. I'm making sure that every strand is coated with this dye. That was my number one goal here. That's what I did, and it came out so good, guys. And this is the finished product after I have applied the dye. You can see the highlights already. Oh my gosh, all I did was wash it and condition it after and air dried it. Put some curls in this bad boy, and this is the finished product, guys. I love how it came out. If you did too, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And thank you guys for watching, and I'll catch you in another one. Bye.